Ed, well, shootings and murders in Chicago on a pace to jump higher than last year, if that's even possible. And that is not lost on the president, who tweeted that if the city didn't fix the problem, he would send in the feds. So would this be warranted, or is that a federal overreach? Here to debate, Republican strategist Gianno Caldwell and Democratic strategist Richard Fowler. Nice to see both of you this morning.
Thank you for having me.
Good to be here, Clayton.
Let's play the sound from Hannity's show the other night so we can put it in context. Here's the president.
Chicago is worse than some of the countries you read about in the Middle East where there's wars going on. Mm-hmm. And there's no reason
for it. It's a war zone.
There is no reason for it.
No reason for it, and it is a war zone. Richard, though, you think his approach about sending the feds in would be a huge mistake. Why?
Well, not only is it an overreach of federal government, right? It's big government intruding into the people of Chicago's lives. But number two, it doesn't solve the problem. Putting tanks on the streets of a major U.S. city isn't the answer. If Donald Trump wants to talk about solutions, he can give me a call. He's probably watching. He could talk to Congresswoman Robin Kelly, who's invited him to the South Side, to have a conversation with the people of Chicago. You can't enforce your will upon people without having a conversation with them about some of the solutions. Or he could help the mayor of Chicago, or call the governor, which he hasn't done, and have them create summer jobs for youth, which we do in here in D.C., which dramatically reduce the crime rate. But
Gianno,
putting
military troops in a major city
isn't the answer.
Gianno, go ahead and jump in on that.
Well, I respect Richard's opinion, but unlike him, I didn't read about the news in Chicago. I lived it. And I can tell you that there was a Democratic state rep by the name of LaShawn Ford who requested the National Guard in 2010. So people in Chicago recognize the fact that there's carnage. There was about 43 shootings last year, shooting victims, I should say, and about 268 this year. And we're only 28 days in. So me being an individual who lived through the crack epidemic, seen violence at every angle of Chicago, recognize that there is a need for federal resources. And President Obama, who really failed Chicago, his adopted hometown, folks in Chicago should acknowledge and accept the help from the federal government. And when President Trump says, I'm going to send the feds, we don't know exactly what that means. Does that mean he's going to send law enforcement? I'm sure. Does that mean there's going to be also resources for summer jobs? Perhaps so. Is there going to be economic strength from that? Perhaps so as well. So I think for us to make some determinations of what that means can really be considered an alternative fact, because we're just making up things at this point.
Right, Richard, you mentioned tanks, but we have no idea of what the president would do with those.
I mean, we've heard over and over again he's going to set in federal resources, but he, according to the governor, Bruce Rauner said Donald Trump hasn't even called him yet, right? So if you want to fix the problem in Chicago, maybe you should have a conversation with Chicago's governor. And what the home audience doesn't know is that I'm from Chicago. I work in Chicago. I'm in Chicago almost once a week, and I could tell you, if you talk to the people of Chicago, they would tell you that putting tanks on the streets.
Richard, you're from Evanston. In order for you to know what the weather's like in Chicago, you gotta read the newspaper.
Week.
You're not from Chicago,
that is
bro.
Not true.
So let's be very honest. No, you're not from Chicago.
I'm telling you, you're providing information
and you don't even know the environment. You didn't live
in
there.
Chicago.
I lived on the south side of Chicago.
Are you out on the Green Line of Philadelphia?
Bruh.
Listen, I work in Chicago once a week, but that doesn't solve the problem. What we need more than anything else is resources.
We gotta go. We appreciate you both joining us this morning, Gianno and Richard.
Good to see you.
Thanks so much.